Task 3 in the series Learn Programming from Scratch is making a calculator. This is how to learn Scratch programming language. The Scratch program language is free, fun, and easy to learn. Most program languages are text-based, so a learner has to gain experience writing the code. But Scratch program is easier as it uses blocks. The learner selects blocks, puts them together, and runs the program in a simple way, making it the most fun and easiest way to learn programming. We'll be using operators like plus, minus, divide, and multiply, and also variables. You can think of a variable as something that can store a value, and you give it a name to be able to retrieve that value, and you can even change that value during the program. Here's some examples. Make sure you subscribe, then you'll know when the videos are released. We won't be looking at the instructions, but if you want to read them, just pause the video. We're going to start off making a calculator using the sensing block of ask and wait. So let's make that bigger so you can see that. So we start off by asking the user to put in a plus or a minus or a asterisk, a star for multiply or divide by. So we need to get an if block. And then we want to see if the answer equals something. So we need an operator block with equals. So if answer equals, and let's say the user puts in a plus. So then we can add a green flag as well. So when we start, ask for the user, do they want a plus, minus, multiply, or divide? If they say plus, then what do we do next? We're going to ask the user to enter the first number, so we can ask them with a looks block. We say something, enter the first number please for 2 seconds, and then we want to get something from the user. So we're going to ask them to start off with, we're just going to ask them for something, and then plus, because they've asked for plus, and then something else equals. Now this is where variables come in, because the answer we want to keep in a variable. So we look for variables and we're going to make a variable. So we're going to create two numbers, so we can create two variables. So we can create a variable called A and click make a variable and create a variable called B. Now we can use set A to and then make that equal the answer. So we have answer. So now we have set A to answer, and that will make the variable A equal the answer from the user. Now getting the second number is going to be very similar, so we can duplicate that code. Now we're going to ask is enter the second number, and we don't ask the question mark, we want to ask with the variable A's value in here. So we can use an operator, because we want to ask something inside here, so we are looking for the correct operator of join. So we can find join and join A. So we have join and the variable A and then plus question mark, so equals. So rather than printing question mark plus question mark, that will print our first value. So that gets our second number from the user. And we can just change the set A to set B. So set B to answer. So B is the second number. Now to confirm what the users just enter, we need to say 2 seconds, but we need to join the A part and the B part with the equals. So we're going to use some joins here. So let's get a join, and we're probably going to use more than one. So we can put joins inside another. So for example, we might have the equals at the end, and then we would have the variable B, and then we need another join because we're going to ask for the plus. So we're going to have the plus, and then we're going to have the A. So we've got join A plus B equals, and let's put that inside a say block. You could use think if you like, but let's just be consistent and use say. Finally, we need to give the answer. So in this case, it's a plus, and we're going to say again, this time for perhaps a bit longer, for 5 seconds. We're going to have A plus B. So because that's a plus rather than a join, that will give us the sum of the two numbers. So we can try that. Let's make that bigger, and let's say plus, enter plus, enter the first number, let's enter 5, enter a second number, let's enter 5 again. 5 plus 5 equals, it equals 10. So that worked correctly. Now something you'll use a lot in coding, in programming, is copy and pasting or duplicating. So here we've got answer equals plus. So we can duplicate all of that, and then answer equals minus, and then we can duplicate both of them. So we go down, and then we can change the options to multiply and divide. So finally, we just go through the different code. The plus we've already done, but the minus, let's move this down. So the minus we've got to change in the ask. So put minus and minus again here in the join, and minus again here. And also the operator, we can use the minus rather than the plus. So let's take that out, use the minus. So we can do that with all of the options. We've got multiply, again multiply, and multiply, option for multiply, divide in a minute. So we'll put A and B, and use that operator, put that in. We've got divide, so we're going to use divide 1, 2, and 3, and again A and B, and the divide So that duplicating all that code has saved a lot of time. Okay, so that's our final code. So you can see we had plus, minus, multiply, and divide. Now it's time to use your imagination. How could you improve the calculator? Try your ideas out and let us know what you did in a comment. Well, we hope you enjoyed that. Now, if you're interested in learning more or learning other programming languages, then please subscribe. And every time a video comes out, if you hit that notification bell, then that will let you know. So enjoy your learning.